Dear students, in this video lecture, we will see the explanation related to nuclear reticulum or chromatin. These are all lightly stained thread-like structures. They are called as a chromatin fibers or chromonema. They form into a network in the nucleoplasm structure. In a simple terms, if you want to say, chromatin is the one which is composed of DNA strands and histone proteins. During cell division, chromatin fibers condense and they form into higher order structure called as a chromosomes. That is, from chromatin, chromosomes are formed. Interface nucleus is the one in which the based on the location and the intensity of staining of the chromatin that can be differentiated into two regions. One is uncoiled, lightly stained euchromatin, which are metabolically active regions. They are involved there in the process of transcription and they are also subjected easily to mutation. However, the other region is a tightly coiled and closely placed with the histone proteins. They are darkly stained and they are highly inactive. They won't be involved there in the transcription process. That region is referred as a heterochromatin region. Now we look at into the composition of this chromatin. Chromatin consists of continuous linear DNA duplex. If you look at into this image, you can able to see the continuous DNA duplex, how it will be present. So this is a continuous DNA duplex. The second one is, it is been associated with a basic proteins, that is called as histones or protamines. These histones are basic protein, are made up of basic amino acids such as arginine and lysine. They are actually positively charged and they will be tightly coupling through electrostatic forces there with the negatively charged DNA molecule. Next one is a acidic or neutral proteins or non-histone molecules. And the fourth one is small amount of a RNA could be present. Some complex proteins that are involved there in the transcription translation process, such as a DNA polymerase, they are involved in the replication, and RNA polymerase, they are associated with the transcription translation, were also present associated there with this region. Some phosphorus containing organic compound and inorganic components like salts were also present there in this particular location. Next, we look at what is meant by nucleosomes. The euchromatin or chromatin in an interface nucleus is in the form of a long chromatin fiber. Under electron microscope, the chromatin fiber will be looking in a beaded appearance or bead on a string appearance. Each bead here is referred as a nucleosome. So in order to understand this thing, we will look at that image. So these are all the bead like structure and then a string like structure. That is the reason it is referred as a bead on string like appearance. So this is the lower order structure of the DNA molecule. It has been converted into a higher order structure, that is the chromosomes. This is possible by uniting of the DNA with the histone molecule. Histone molecule are the one which is mainly involved in packing the DNA. So now we are looking at what is a nucleosome. The nucleosome is some basic structure of an eukaryotic chromosome, that is chromatin, consists of about 146 base pairs of the DNA. So the wounded thing is made up of 146 base pairs of DNA that have been associated with the core of 8 histone molecules. So this is the core of 8 histone molecules. These histone molecules are in turn made up of alkaline protein, that is arginine and lysine. Now we look at the structures or explanation for the nucleosomes, what we have seen in the image. So the nucleosome consists of a core histone molecule, that is an octamer, that is made up of 8 histone molecules that will be having H2A, H2B, H3 and H4 type of histones. The next one, double stranded DNA fragment is wrapped upon the core particle, that is made up of histone, and this DNA fragment will be of a 146 base pair nucleotide long and it forms into one coil. So this coil is the one you are seeing here. So this is a one coil that is made up of a 146 base pair containing DNA molecule that is wound there on a core 8 histone molecule. The whole thing will be sealed with the help of a different histone, that is histone 1. And naturally, this histone 1 is a least conserved form of histone. A linker DNA is the one which is connecting the adjacent nucleosome. This linker DNA is in turn made up of 60 base pairs long and it connects the two adjacent nucleosomes. So if you look at here, you can able to see the linker DNA. So this is a linker DNA connecting one nucleosome with the other. So this is also called as a bead on string like appearance. This is a string and these are looking like a beads. So this is the level at which the DNA molecules are getting packed there inside the cell. You look at this image. This image clearly explains how the DNA molecule is getting packed and forming into the chromosome. Okay. So it can be asked in a synonymous way as organization of chromosomes or DNA packing or a higher order structure of DNA. How you are getting a higher order structure of DNA. So if you look at into the first one, a short region of DNA double helix have been present that is having a very small size, that is of a 2 nanometer. However, the next level of organization is a bead on string like appearance that forms the chromatin. Okay, so you can able to see a bead which is made up of octamer of histone on which 146 base pair DNA has been coiled and the adjacent nucleosomes are connected with the help of a linker DNA which is in turn made up of 60 base pairs of DNA. So this is the one we are having a little more bigger size, that is 11 nanometer. The next size is a 30 nanometer chromatin fiber that have been packed into a nucleosome structures. Now a part of the things is extended and it is shown as a section of chromosome in extended form that is around a 300 nanometer size. Further level of higher order structure is a condensed section of a metaphase chromosome that is still higher, that is around 700 nanometer in size. And finally, the image shows the completely condensed DNA molecule that is chromatin form to chromosome. This is the one which is visible during the metaphase. You look at the size of that particular molecule, higher size, say for example 1400 nanometer. So a very small size with a 2 nanometer has been packed upon itself. That is the organization of chromosomes or DNA packing or a higher order structure for the DNA later results in the formation of a 1400 nanometer chromosome, the higher order structure. Functions of the chromatin. What are the functions performed by chromatin? Chromatin is a hereditary material. Naturally, it's made up of DNA. So it is an hereditary material. It forms the chromosome, that is the higher order structure formation during the process of cell division, especially during the metaphase of the cell division. Next, we look at the points related to nucleus. It controls all metabolic activities of the cell. Nucleus controls the inheritance of characters from parents to their offsprings. It is the one which controls cell division. Mammalian RBCs are those one in which you cannot able to see the nucleus. As a result, they cannot further able to grow or divide or undergo a cell repair. That is the reason within a span of 120 days, they will be dying or it will be replaced with the new RBC cells.